Periscope, what's up? Greg Howes, Monday morning. God bless you. Good to see you this morning. Good morning, good morning. Good morning, good morning. That's your song. All right. I picked the right one. Christmas week. Moving into it. High energy today, Monday morning. Hope you had a great weekend. Hope everything was well for you over the weekend. Absolutely. Good morning, good morning, good morning. You have your coffee yet? You ready to go? Got some coffee going? What you having for breakfast? High energy today. Come on. High energy. Need some oatmeal. Good. All right, all right. Grit or grits? Well, you eat your grits and we'll talk about grit. Yeah, you having gum? Okay, that's a nice breakfast. Mountain Dew, Lord of mercy. Wow. There. Mountain Dew will get you stirred up. Good morning, good morning. High energy. High energy. Almond milk with coffee. All right, all right. Coffee, almond milk. How was church yesterday? Christmas Sunday. Did you have a good day yesterday? Christmas Sunday. We had a great time at Cornerstone. Our creative arts department did a knockout job. Drama, music, worship team, dance team, choir, children. It was awesome. It was awesome. We had a great time. Yeah, we had a great time yesterday. Great time. There is some of it on Periscope and on my Facebook wall if you want to go back and check it out so you can take a look at it. Really good yesterday. Really, really good. We had a great, great time. We had a great time. I hope yours was good too. Absolutely. So it's Monday. We're heading into Christmas week. And it's an exciting time. I know some of you are probably still working this week. Others may have the week off. If you're a student, of course, you most likely have the week off. This is Christmas break time, so it's an exciting time of year. December 21st today, I think isn't this the shortest day of the year? I think. I know my son kept talking about how dark it was this morning. Of course, that might be because it's raining here in Chicago. Kind of rainy today, but it's a good day. Happy Mindset Monday, absolutely. High energy. Teachers are off too, yeah. Teachers are off. All the schools are closed this week and next week. So God bless you. Enjoy your time off. Last week, we were talking quite a bit about innovation and entrepreneurship. And I just want to move more into that vein starting today on Monday. Amen. You're from Chicago. All right. God bless you. And we want to just continue to define some things and look at some things concerning entrepreneurship, because as I was telling you last week, I believe that entrepreneurship is part of the DNA that God puts into our lives. If you look at the major characters in Scripture, you'll find some entrepreneurship qualities in their lives. They were people that were innovators, they were creative, they were launching new things, stepping out and accomplishing things by faith that no one else was daring to accomplish. And so they really were innovators. They were introducing something new. New things, new methods were being brought to bear on the people of God. They were pioneers, they were commencing new things, they were initiating new things. People in the New Testament especially, as well as the Old, they were entrepreneurs that knew how to plan things, they knew how to organize things, and they knew how to launch things, getting things moving. So I really believe that entrepreneur spirit is something that comes to us from God. It comes to us from God. And if we as a people of God can tap into that, DNA that's inside of us, I believe that we can move into some very prevalent areas of our society and accomplish some great things. That there's no reason why some of your names cannot be up there with the names of people like Steve Jobs or Bill Gates, Warren Buffett, people of that category, Oprah Winfrey, just all the names that start popping up when you think in those terms. There's no reason why we as the people of God cannot move into those realms of entrepreneurship and innovation and creativity and accomplish some great things in the culture, in the society as well. So I want to encourage you to move in that direction. So that means that you're going to have to be a risk taker. If you're an entrepreneur, if you're an innovator, you're going to be required to be a risk taker. You're going to be an organizer. You're going to be an innovator. You're going to be an innovator. You're going to be a leader. So you're going to be moving in all of those things and believing God to accomplish something wonderful through your life. It means you're going to have a desire to achieve. That's going to be part of your entrepreneurship. It's going to require hard work. There's going to be nurturing involved where you are willing to watch over a venture until it can stand on its own. You will accept responsibility. You're going to show yourself to be accountable. There's an optimism about you. There's an excellence about you, a quality of excellence, desiring to achieve something just absolutely outstanding. You're going to be looking for a profit, P-R-O-F-I-T, but also you're going to be moving as a prophet, P-R-O-P-H-E-T, in the sense that you're going to see what's coming. You're going to be able to look into the future and be able to determine what is coming down the pike, so to speak, and you'll be ahead of the game. So I want you to just tap into that. And I also want to encourage you to move into the realms of social media. Social media, that's a critical area in this season that we're in right now. So if you're not already in social media, you need to launch out and get involved with that. Get involved with Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and Snapchat and LinkedIn, all of these different social media outlets. You need to be engaged with those because those are tools that we can use not only to propagate our business or the gospel, but it becomes a tool for the glory of God. So I want to encourage you to get involved and engage with social media. And in all of this, you are going after something better. You're always looking for something better. Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 16 tells us that we are a people who are desiring something better. And if we are looking for something better, then God is not ashamed to be called our God. In other words, God likes it when we reach for something good. When we are going for improvement, when we're going for excellence, God likes that kind of stuff. And he's going to come and stand with us and partner with us in that endeavor. And then Luke chapter 1 and verse 53 tells us that God has filled the hungry with good things. So whenever we're hungry for something better, whenever we desire a higher level, whenever we desire excellence, God is going to fill us up. He's going to satisfy that place of hunger. Now, one of the very prevalent words coming up in business life today is the word grit. G-R-I-T, grit. You might remember a few years ago there was a movie, a John Wayne movie that was called True Grit, and they redid the movie just a few years ago with some more up-to-date modern characters. I think Matt Damon might have been in it. True Grit, and I want us to begin to look at this word grit as it pertains to business life, as it pertains to our ministry life, and begin to see how grit can help us moving forward. So when you think of the word grit, what kind of ideas come to your mind? Just give me a few suggestions. Come on, get your fingers moving there and type in some things. When you think of the word grit, what is it that comes to mind? You like to eat grits. That's not the kind of grit I'm talking about. Not grits, grit, G-R-I-T, grit. When you think of grit, there it is, tenacious, yeah, tenacious. Dig in there and get it done. Yeah, that's good, I like that. What does it mean to have grit? Hard work, yeah, tenacity, determination, toughness, be determined, yeah. Sandpaper, okay. Longevity, never give up, absolutely. All of those are good, strong, determined, thick-skinned, Great words, great terminology for the word grit. Focus, courage, the ability to see it through. Quaker Oats. Who is this? We got a jokester on here today. We got jokes. Quaker Oats. All right. Confidence, hardy, never quit. Endure hardness as a good soldier. Yeah, that's scriptural, isn't it? Endurance. Yeah. Very good. Grit. There's a gentleman by the name of John Gordon, J-O-N, Gordon, G-O-R-D-O-N. John Gordon is a person that's really pushing this idea of grit right now. You might want to check him out on Twitter and Facebook. John Gordon, he says that grit is the key predictor of success. The key predictor of success. And you need to understand that a big part of grit, G-R-I-T, not grits, the kind you eat, but grit, the quality that we want in our lives. A big part of grit is knowing that outside circumstances and people have no power over us. That we create our own world from the inside out. We create our own world from the inside out. So grit is the ability to persevere, to overcome. It's the ability to move forward in spite of challenges, failures, and obstacles. Grit is passion. It's perseverance. It's an attitude that you carry in your life. Grit is the stamina that we exercise in whatever we're doing. It is grit is sticking with your future. It's sticking with your future day in and day out, even if it takes years to fulfill your destiny. Grit is working really hard work to make your future a reality. Grit is living life like it's a marathon and not a sprint. That is grit. Grit is optimism plus confidence plus creativity along with resilience. If you put all of that together, you're beginning to get a picture of what grit is all about. Optimism, confidence, creativity, and resilience. It has to do with grit. Grit means you never give up. You never give up. You never quit. Grit means you keep showing up every day. Just keep showing up. That's a real key to success, you know. Just keep showing up. Do the work. Do the work that you've been given to do. And I like this. Listen to this. Gritty people believe that everything will be all right in the end. And if it's not all right yet, that only means it's not the end yet. I like that. I like that a lot. You know, grit is a part of the apostolic gift. It's a part of the apostolic grace. Romans chapter 5, verses 3 and 4, scripture says, we glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance. And perseverance, character, and character, hope. So perseverance is the biblical word for grit. Perseverance. 2 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 12 talks about the signs of an apostle. And one of the signs of an apostle is grit. It's perseverance. Perseverance. 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 10. Paul tells Timothy, you have carefully followed my doctrine. You see my manner of life. You see my purpose, my faith, my love, and my perseverance. You see my grit, so to speak. 2 Peter chapter 1 and verse 6 tells us, it's going through a list there of adding things to our lives, adding virtues. And it says, once you have self-control, then you add perseverance to self-control. Romans chapter 8 and verse 25 says, if we hope for what we do not see, we eagerly wait for it with perseverance. So whatever we're expecting, whatever we're looking for, whatever we're hoping for, we do it with perseverance. We do it with grit. Now that involves whatever we're believing God for. It involves ministry. It involves your business life as well. Whatever you're expecting, whatever you're hoping for, put some grit in it, put some perseverance in it, and keep moving until you see it happen. Hallelujah. Well, I think that's good for today. I appreciate you being on the broadcast with me today. God bless you so much. I hope that this day is going to be a great day for you as you begin this Christmas week. Keep moving forward. Exercise that perseverance. Get that grit up in your life. Move with grit. Stir up the grit. And eat some grits while you're at it. Yeah. I love you. I appreciate you. I'm grateful for you. Thank you for being on the broadcast today. God bless you so much. I hope you have a great day. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. God bless you.